Hey everybody, it's Darcy. Hope you're having a great day. Today's painting episode is on a hooded crow from Europe. And I'm trying a couple things different over the next few videos. One of the things is I'm starting a little poll question. I've learned how to do that. And it's just, the question is, if you have a large number of crows, and what is it called? So the choices are flock, Google, murder, and gathering, I think. Anyway, so answer the question and we'll see how that works. I'm not sure how it works on YouTube, so we'll see how it goes. But thanks for tuning in and hope you have a great day. Here we go. So this hooded crow, it's actually a beautiful bird. I think in North America, we're all used to typically seeing and have the realization that crows are all blackbirds, growing up at, you know, Halloween and horror stories and everything. But this, the hooded crow in Europe and Britain is actually a gray beard with a black feathered pattern on its head and on its chest. And what that does is it makes it quite an attractive bird. I think it does suffer a little bit from an identity crisis, because it seems like every country in Europe has a different name for this bird. In Scotland, they refer to them as hoodies. In Ireland, they're known as grey crows. They're also known as just a Danish crow in Denmark. And a few other various names like that, but it's basically all the same bird. And it intermingles with its very familiar cousin, the carrion crow, just to give it another issue of self-identity. I don't know if birds go through that or not. The really good news about this bird is there's lots of them, not on the endangered list at all, so they're going to be around for a while. They are carrion birds, so they actually eat meat, sometimes smaller birds, lots of insects. They tend to get their food and then they'll hide it, for example in eaves troughs or under a bush. And the other little sneaky thing about these things is they'll also watch other crows, and they'll stay at a distance, watch where they hide their food, and then they'll go in and swoop in and take it from them. The other neat thing is they hang around water a fair bit when they can, and they'll pick up sea urchins or shells. And they'll pick them up, fly up really high, and drop these sea urchins. They crack open when they hit the ground, and then they'll go in and eat the meat. But what's left over is a bunch of these half shells sort of sitting all over the ground, and that's where the name crow cup comes from, because they look like little cups that the crows have left all over the place. Beautiful birds, really a large bird. They're not 100% sure of the lifespan. They've seen them up to 30 years, but I think it's much lower than that. The other neat thing about them is they're quite big. They have a wingspan almost to 100 centimeters. And if you think about that, that's the size of a yardstick. That's pretty big. And they can also be quite tall. So not your typical small little blackbird that we're used to in North America. They are quite big. Now we're going to just touch on some quick trivia. At the beginning of the video, there's a poll, and it was, what do you call a gathering of a large number of crows? The correct answer, I'm not sure if you got this or not, but it's actually called a murder of crows. Now, the reason behind why they call it a murder of crows is because a group of crows in literature and stuff, they widely use the term murder because it's based on the folk tale that crows form little tribunals together to judge and punish the bad behavior of members of their flock. So if the verdict goes wrong against the defendant, which is another bird, then that bird is murdered by the flock. So a little bit of a folk tale there, a little bit more dumb trivia. You can bring it up on your next date out with your spouse, boyfriend, girlfriend, or significant other, and you will look like a superstar. Anyway, we're getting near the end here. Thanks for sticking in with me. Got a nice number of subscribers now, still looking for more, so if you can Like and subscribe, and sharing is always a really neat thing because that means you liked it enough that you've shared it with other people. Looking for additional ideas for painting too, so feel free to leave a comment below. It might take me a while to get your request done, but I've so far my success rate is 100% getting them done. I don't know if the people liked seeing the end result or not. So just as a final goodbye, hope everyone has a great day. And this was filmed on the 74th anniversary of Operation Overlord, also known as D-Day, when the Canadians and the Americans and the British all went over into Normandy, France, and started the push against the Nazis and the Germans. So today is a day we should all be proud of. Anyway, I've got to go. I seem to have got a flock of crows in my kitchen here trying to get into my dog's dog food. So I've got to get these little buggers out of here. You have a great day, and thanks again. Hey, get away from there. Don't talk back to me.